Microsoft is stepping up its game against Sony. It wants to convince gamers that Xbox is better than PlayStation. And it's using Windows 10 as part of the pitch. CNET senior editor Jeff Bacalar is here with me. Thanks so much for being here.
Of course.
So how does Windows 10 upgrade play into Microsoft's pitch?
So Microsoft's using that leverage, saying, hey, Windows 10 is not only a great operating system, it's fantastic for gamers. And it's kind of true. That is the best operating system to play games on if you're using a computer. So they're sort of using that leverage and saying, hey, the best place to play games is this Windows 10 environment. And Xbox One, which is the console separate from PCs, is getting this sort of Windows 10 refresh. And a lot of that functionality is going to be shared across platforms. You're going to be able to stream Xbox One games to your Windows 10 PC and be able to sort of live in that Xbox Live environment. So they're using this sort of two-sided approach at attracting gamers.
So the Xbox will be able to record video. How does that play into Microsoft's entertainment and gaming
so
strategy?
This is a little dicey. It's going to have DVR capabilities, but only stuff that's over the air. So you won't really be able to record anything on premium cable channels. It's just stuff that would be streamed over the air through like an antenna. And I think they're going, the way it sounds like it's going to be implemented, is that they're going to limit what channels you can record using their guide. So you'll see channels that'll have DVR capable, and then you'll see channels that normally wouldn't be able to be recorded because they're not over the air.
So what other updates does Microsoft have planned?
So for Xbox One, they're going to get all this backwards compatibility. That was a big sticking point as the console generation began about a year and a half ago. The old legacy console, Xbox 360, all those games were just sort of done. Mm-hmm. And if you owned an Xbox One, you couldn't play. There was no support. Now they're introducing, slowly but surely, rolling out compatibility with about 100 titles, and that will be available starting this November.
All right, Jeff Bacalar, thanks so much.
Of course.